Okay, you've made it past the first round. Not too shabby. I'm sure Mr. Vitale will agree there's still plenty of games left to play, and one of them is this second round game between the Texas Tech Red Raiders and the San Diego State Aztecs.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Aztecs know this isn't going to be an easy one. What's the key for them tonight, Dick?
Hey, the keys for them tonight are simple. Number one, I look for the point guard to be in control of the team out there. He's got to be the leader. He's got to be the boss. He's got to be in command. Second, beware of turnovers. Protect the basketball. You want to minimize the amount of free possessions that you give to the opposition. And finally, play solid fundamental defense and don't get caught gambling.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court, and let's get the action underway. Both teams looking to get things going here. Here's the offensive drop step, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Off the rim and no good. Jumps in. Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. Number 32 handles the feed. The ball goes out of bounds. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
In the paint. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Inside.
Now trying to feed the low block, and he'll kick it back outside. He takes a three, way off target. The point guard handles the pass. For two, in and out. The point guard receives the ball. They go into the low block. The center receives the pass. He up fakes. Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I tell you, he took a chance, and he lost, baby.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. They go inside, and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket. Trying to feed the low block. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline with Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
Double team now, bad angle.
Tries for two, and in and out. Down inside. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. He buries it. Here's a nice face-up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
The skip pass is picked off. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Makes the second shot. From three-point territory, off the rim and no good. Looking for contact. Number 34 with a finger roll. Time to pick up the defense here now. From left of the circle, drains the shot. When you're talking about the Big 12, people often mention Texas, Kansas, Oklahoma.
Yeah, Brad, they do. But it'll be interesting to see how or if the recent coaching changes will affect the style of play that the Big 12 is known for.
Fakes the shot, and he'll kick it back outside. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player, and they made an error, obviously, but they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what, let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Can't get the shot to drop. They're working around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. Number 13 is pounded on his way up. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Gets two at the charity stripe. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Looking for a good shot. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Easy one. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Spin move's not going to work against the defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Great job of freeing himself with the screen, but shot won't go.
Marries it home. Now the turnaround jumper. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Terrible execution on offense. He keeps his dribble as they reset. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. Shoots from outside. He buries the shot. There's a bad pass right to the defender. The dribble, gives it up. They'll work it around the arc. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land. goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He lets it go.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet jet.
Looking for a good shot.
Ah, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. Pounding the ball with his neck. Where's he going?
Pulls the trigger, sinks it.
Here it is.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
He goes to the line, shooting three. Misses the first. He hits it. No good. He gets the rebound. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
For the bucket. In and out.
Ooh, look at a shot block. We got some contact. Nice hops.
Got to make that, baby. Had that wide open angle. Have a chance to lay it on the glass for easy goals.
For two. And he missed. Attempts the Hail Mary. They're really losing confidence with their poor shooting at the time, Dick.
Hey, nothing that a couple of fast break dunks could cure.
At the end of the first half, the Aztecs are ahead by eight. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He tries to knock down the three. Way off target. The point guard gets the ball. Dumps it in. With a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
Pressure that basketball.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. And in and out. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Gave it up.
High post screen.
Easy one. The Red Raiders are trailing by six. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Moving it around the perimeter. Picks off the lazy pass. Tries for two. Up. Easy one.
Coming inside.
Steals the pass. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
On the dribble, gives it up. Number 32, pump fakes. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
A high screen. The Aztecs lead by six. That's good defense. A steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Let's take a look right here.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Got to take some pride on a defensive end.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. For the deuce. And he missed. Picked out of the air. On the inside. And they come with a double team to stop it. Come up with a steal, and they do. The power forward takes the pass.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there and let him think about it for a while.
Goes up for two. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
That's a 9-0 run.
Had him in the low block, but opted against it. The center, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense, poor job defensively. Don't get back, don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert, get the number game going.
About ready for play to resume. They work the perimeter. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
For two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic. Five-second call approaching.
Tries for two. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Gave it up. The shooting guard with the ball. Rims out. Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. He'll visit the charity stripe. Hits the first shot. Makes the second shot. They work it around the perimeter. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside though is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball. Great play to take that to the basket.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Number 34 is animated and ready to go.
Hey, Brad, I love players that play with emotion. That's why I love the college game.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. He launches the bomb. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Pump fakes.
There's the trap.
From a different area, Cole. You bet. For the bucket. He drains the bucket. He intercepts it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The point guard gets the pass. There's a double team waiting there. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad.
Takes the three-pointer. Makes the shot. Oh, hard screen felt by the defender. On the dribble, gives it up. Gave it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
It's a nine-point lead.
Well, 9 points still keeps you in the game, though, Brad. They can't have a breakdown here, though.
He drains it.
That's basic.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
On the dribble, gives it up. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love that. Foul, and that stops the clock again. And yet another foul. and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Number 42 steps to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Second shot, good. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Working it around the perimeter. Great defense. We've got a timeout on the floor. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
He tries the three ball. Off the rim and no good.
High post screen, going to use it.
Picked off. Gave it up. Throws up the prayer. Rims out. Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
Texas Tech is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.